Welcome to Morning Manna with Pastor Steve Myrie. Today's topic, first, defeat the lion. And David said to Saul, let no man's heart fail because of him. Thy servant will go and fight with this Philistine. And Saul said to David, thou art not able to go against this Philistine to fight with him, for thou art but a youth, and he a man of war from his youth. David said, thy servant slew a lion and a bear, and this uncircumcised Philistine shall be as but one of them, seeing he hath defiled the armies of the living God. 1 Samuel 17, 32 through 36. You will never defeat the giant unless you first conquer the lion and the bear. Everyone listening this morning have heard the story of David and Goliath. Consider David, the young man that came off the shepherd's field, didn't come off the field unprepared. While he was there, probably not doing what he wanted to do, while he was tending to the flock, his brothers were out in the war. He probably had rather been a soldier. His brothers were hiding, but David was ready to fight. And this is probably because of what happened while he was tending to the sheep. David had confidence. The confidence David had came from what God helped him to do while he was taking care of the sheep. The Bible says that there came a lion and a bear. Listen, the enemy is not afraid of the flock. The enemy doesn't stop at the back door of the church. The enemy doesn't stop just because we're Pentecostals, or because we were saved, or because we're filled with the Holy Ghost. Isn't that just like the devil? He makes us fearful. He talks to us and persuades us that we cannot conquer. Child of God, you'll never get away from running from your problems, nor your situations, nor your burdens. You'll never conquer anything by running from them. But the best thing that you can do is to run to them and conquer them. Somebody said, well, preacher, I want to live a life for God where there's no problem or sorrows or no troubles. Well, let me confess, me too. But I haven't found that life yet. But every battle, every hardship makes me look over my shoulder and say the same God that brought me through that will bring me through this one. But the objective of the enemy is to plant fear in your heart, that you believe that you're not going to make it. If he can plant a seed to make you think that you're not going to make it. But I came by here this morning just to let somebody know, greater is he that is in you than he that is in the world. You've got to conquer your lion. You've got to conquer your bear, or you'll never win the battle with the giant. If you're going to live for God, then you better be ready to give up some things. It's gonna cost you some time. It's gonna cost you some prayers. It's gonna cost you some dedication. It's gonna cost you standing in the midst of your fiery trials. Child of God, somewhere in your Christian walk, you're gonna meet up with a 9 feet 9 inches tall giant. And unless God's brought you through some victories, you'll never stand before him. The thought of the day: you've got to conquer your lion. You've got to conquer your bear, or you'll never win the battle with the giant. God bless you today, in Jesus' name.
Please remember to like and subscribe to my page on YouTube. Your support is much appreciated.
Hey, we make a miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness.